Welcome to the Course Podcast. My name is Milan Pierre-Jerome, and I'm your host. And today I'm here with NYAH, Mike, SAYLOR, JADA, and Anthony, some athletes I met a couple weeks ago at an NCAA Leadership Forum. And today's episode is going to be a little bit different. It's a part of the new segment, the Athlete Linkup, where we're just going to be talking about what we go through as athletes. And yeah, so how's everyone doing today?
Great.
Doing well over here.
Good, good. So can y'all just introduce yourselves, say where you're from, sport, fun facts, just go around.
I'm
Anthony Egbo. I go to Abilene Christian. I play football. Originally from Houston. And fun fact is my whole family's from Nigeria, so.
I'm Mike Red. I play football at the University of Miami. I'm originally from Pensacola, Florida. And one thing about me, I know how to juggle.
My name is Nia Leverretter. I'm a junior playing basketball at the University of Kentucky, but I'm originally from Blythewood, South Carolina. A fun fact about me is I was raised as a military brat.
Hi, I'm SAYLOR Hawkins. I go to the University of North Texas. I'm a diver, originally from Minnesota. And a fun fact about me is I have a pet snake.
Hi, my name is Jada Moss. I go to Clayton State University and I play women's basketball down there. A fun fact about me is that I have a pet dog named Equality.
I like that. All right. So yeah, so we're starting this episode just talking about the Leadership Forum, and we're going to have NYAH just run you guys through what we experienced in the whole 4 days. So
yeah. So it was really fun. We all went to Baltimore, and we got to be in rooms with people who play Division I, Division II, Division III sports, administrators and coaches too. And we were all like mixed in little groups for about 4 days just to talk about different topics about leadership. And some of the things we talk about were just being emotionally aware of your own habits of yourself as a leader, how they, you know, go with how you act as a leader. We talked about emotional intelligence. We talked about our mindsets. We talked about different scenarios of leadership that happen across the board in our teams. And then besides that, we also got to, you know, talk to people who work for SAC and higher levels to understand how NCAA governance works and all those type of things, just to make us a better, well-rounded athlete, person, leader to take back to our own teams and schools respectively.
Good, good. So, you know, we were talking, we had like a little talk at the end, and we were all saying how in the beginning, we just walked in, knew nobody. Everyone just walked in, sat by themselves. Everyone was quiet. So Anthony, can you talk about how, when you walked in, like how everything just changed, like just walk us through your first day and how that went?
Yeah. So like the first day I was honestly nervous because obviously, like, I didn't know anybody. But I knew the other rep for my conference. We kind of, like, met before the conference. So we flew together. Like, we had the same flight. So we were, like, talking the whole time. So, like, that kind of made me feel better. But then, obviously, we're in different teams. So, like, we split up. But really, I was just, like, you know, just trying to be the cool guy. I put my head down, like, I'm just coming here to learn. I don't care about nobody, type of vibe. But when we got into our teams, we started meeting, like, the other people in our, like, different teams. That's when, like, everything changed because, like, everybody basically was in the same boat. Like, nobody knew nobody. So, like, once we all, like, just started talking to each other, that's when, like, you just kind of felt at home. And then the first night when we went, we walked the harbor. And everybody was just, like, it was weird because it was, like, everybody, it felt natural just to talk to anybody. Like, it was legit random people, but then you just, like, go up to somebody and be like, where are you from? And then you just start talking, and then next thing you know, y'all are best friends. So, like, it was really cool doing that.
Yeah, the first night was actually crazy because, like, I wasn't supposed to go to the harbor. I was going to stay in my room. I was going to do homework. And then someone I met in my team was like, oh, we should just walk to the harbor. So we were walking, and there was a whole group, and that's where Jada, Anthony and Sailor were, and I saw them, and me and Anthony, we just, it's like we were friends for like 10 years. Like, we were just talking, like, where are you from? Oh, and then we saw Jada, and then Jada brought us to her group, and it was just instant, like, just having a conversation. So, Jada, how was that moment for you where you just saw how easy it was to talk to people?
Honestly, it was just kind of like a really cool experience for me, considering that I'm not a very talkative person. But like, once, you know, I won rock, paper, scissors or whatever, like it was like easy for me to like build a conversation off that. And then also, like, I thought it was really cool that, like, no matter if you were Division I, Division II, Division III, it didn't matter in that moment. Like, we were all athletes and all had like common stories. So then I also like take back to the night where we did meet at the harbor, and then we ventured off in Baltimore, then came back to Milan's room, and we sat up and talked for 3 hours like we'd known each other forever. It was just a really cool experience all around.
So, yes, it was. And Sailor, you know, you were there too. So I know you're not that talkative, but when we were talking in my room, we stayed up till like 3 o'clock in the morning just talking. So how would you say that was, like, just being able to talk and just open up with us?
I really enjoyed it. At the beginning, I was real nervous. I didn't know anybody. But I think after, like you guys said, walking to the harbor, it made us a lot more comfortable. And, like, just getting into the room and talking about more things than just being a leader or being an athlete brought us closer and just made me feel a little bit more comfortable.
Mm-hmm. Yes. So then the next day, for me personally, that's when I met Mike, and, you know, we all just, everyone was just meeting mutuals. Like, I had Anthony Sailor, I had NYAH, and then NYAH brought me to her friends. So it was just like a good event in that aspect. So Mike, what would you say this experience did for you?
For me, it kind of got me out of my comfort zone. You know, I did like a lot of things. I'm very like quiet too, but once I get kind of around like the right people, you know, we start going to places. Like, you remember that night? Like, we did karaoke night that night. You know what I'm saying? And that's the first time I ever did that. You know, like, normally I wouldn't. That's outside of my comfort zone. So kind of meeting like different people and having those people kind of pull me kind of outside of my comfort zone, kind of let me look at things from a like different perspective or experience different things that I normally don't experience.
So can you tell them what song you did for karaoke?
Can You Stay in the Rain? Yes.
Good choice.
Good job too. He was singing a whole restaurant was.
Yeah, me and Tommy was going off that night. Yeah. Hey, everybody went off that night. So yeah.
Thanks. And what did I sing again? When I See You. I did When I See You. That was by myself. I don't do that. That was insane. Whole restaurant. Like, I don't know what I was on.
Hey, Anthony got up there too though. Anthony.
He
got
did
up there
Anthony,
too,
what song did you do? What song
he did
you do?
T-Pain.
Buy You a Drink.
Yeah. Hey, Anthony went off too.
So all the moms are like,
yeah. Nah, I set it off. Yeah, I set it off. And then Mike and them took over after that.
Yeah. You finally got comfortable. But yeah, so NYAH, you know, our story is a little bit different. We had a mutual friend, and I saw NYAH at a meeting. I was like, I know this girl. Like, I don't know where I seen this girl. I know this girl. And then after I call my friend, and I'm like, please tell. And then he tells me, oh my gosh, my girlfriend. I was like, NYAH, yes, NYAH. So I don't know, just for us, like, it was a different experience. You know, we've seen each other, and, you know, over the week, we were able to just grow closer and just see, like, how this event has just, like, transformed both of us. So how was the experience for you?
The experience was really amazing, really eye-opening, and it's so hard to, like, put that into words if you haven't experienced it. But I would just say, like, it was so crazy just being around so many like-minded people, because, I mean, I understand we all have our different teams, but we're captains, we're leaders on our team and at our school for a reason, because we think a certain way, we have a different perspective on things. And it was just so cool being able to be around so many people that think the same way or similarly to I do. And yeah, like you said, like, we just instantly clicked, I think, honestly. And I don't know if that's just because, like, you know, we know somebody, or we both want to do kind of like sports journalism or anything like that. And then, like you're saying, like, even just the people that you knew, it just felt like we've known everybody for years when we really just met in that moment. I think too, just the sessions, like they made us open up, they made us so vulnerable that we were able to like grow those relations really fast. And I don't know, I was so nervous going into this event, but like if I hadn't gone and I knew I was going to miss out on these type of relationships and experience, I would have been so sad.
Mm-hmm. Facts. We have a group chat now texting it like happy birthday, Sailor's birthday was the other day, like now we're locked in. Like I remember when we walked in the first day and what's his name, he was like, so you guys are gonna think I'm crazy, but these people sitting in this room are gonna be at your wedding. And I was like, who? Like, there's 4 days. We are not gonna know these people for long. There is no way. Like, there's no way. And now y'all will be at my wedding. Y'all will be there. Like, it's just crazy how like he said it and he called it. And now we're like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's just, I don't know. But so what would you say your favorite part was? Anyone could talk, whatever you want to say, your favorite part of the whole week.
I feel like just your transformation throughout the week. I would say like how close you were, like, well, from my experience, how close I got with my color team. Like when I first went in there, I just sat down, had my head down. I was like, I'm not about to speak. I ain't gonna say nothing. And then it's just like, I kind of had to open up and be like, you know, Jada, you're here for a reason. Like you don't want to leave the same way you came in type thing. And the theme of the forum was beyond the box. Mm-hmm. And I feel like everybody went beyond the box. Like we all were there for a reason. We all like participated and stuff like that. And my color team made me feel very, very comfortable, like invulnerable. And me on the last day, like I think everybody did that exercise where we closed our eyes and just visualized the person that got us to the seat that we were in today. And like, that made me super duper emotional because my mother and my grandmother are the reason why I was in that seat. All the sacrifice, all the hard work, so they poured so much into me. And it was just like cool to see like, wow, like out of everybody that's in my conference, like I'm the only person from my sports team. Like I was the only person out of 3 sports teams, like in my whole entire conference that like was representing. So I felt like that was really cool for me. That was like my best like takeaway from the whole experience.
That's real. Anyone else, their favorite part of the weekend, week?
I would say I would say my favorite part would probably just be seeing like the transition in my habits as a person, not even just a leader. So like, I'm a very talkative person. If something's going on, I'm like the first person to raise my hand. But when I went there and I was with my color team, like I wanted to hear different perspectives. Like I didn't always want to be the person inputting things to other people. So I feel like for me, just hitting that switch and being okay with listening and being the person to take some ideas from other people, I think that was my favorite part of the experience.
Yeah, that's real. Anthony?
Yeah, I was gonna say, honestly, my favorite part, like there's a lot of like parts I could say is my favorite, but probably one of the most like best moments that we had was just when we were at the hotel, like in Millie's room, like that night. And it was like Tamaya, Jada, you, Tommy, Sailor. And like, it was just crazy to me because I'm like, I think I met y'all that night.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we did.
And then it was like that night. And then we were up till like almost 4 a.m. But like, we were talking legit, like we grew up together. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, I'm just sitting there like, what is happening? Because like, we talking about some deep stuff. We talking about life. We talking about death. We talking about
everything.
Our goals. We talking about like some deep stuff. And I'm like, why do I feel like I could just say whatever I want to say right now? Like, or why is everybody like talking like we just are been locked in forever? And it was just like in that moment, I realized like, there's so many people like we haven't met yet, or there's just so many people out there. Like the world is just so much bigger than what we're accustomed to seeing every day. Like we're like in our environments, we're at our schools, wherever we grew up. But like, there's so many more, like there's so much more to life. There's so much more to the world. Like I would never have met y'all. And I'm like, there's legit people that think like me, like, or like think like at a higher level than me, or like, you know what I mean, or like that cool. I'm like, that was crazy to me, because like we low-key like met on a fluke. Like I was just like, we're just walking in different groups and we just happened to like merge at the same time when we're walking on the harbor. Like we weren't even like supposed to be around each other. And I'm like, I could have easily just missed y'all, like, but it's just crazy. Like that moment for me just made me realize, like, I was just grateful to meet y'all and just grateful to like experience that. Like there's just dope people in the world.
Facts. Yeah, no, for me, like, I'm just gonna say my favorite part off of what he just said. You know, I'm a believer, so everything happens for me for a reason. So us meeting at the harbor, Nye and I sitting across from each other, and like everything happens for a reason. So to see it like in front of me is just, it was just insane. Like after the last day, Nye and I were just woohoo crying. I was like, I don't want to leave. Like it just, the whole experience was just something that like I will never be able to forget, because being able to know that there's other people out there like me is something that just makes me happy. Like I could have coworkers one day that I just won't like, and that I can't control that, but knowing that I have y'all five out there just doing you and being successful is something that will keep me going. So yeah. Mike, Sayla, you want to talk about your favorite parts?
So my favorite part was, I got a lot of takeaway from this, but mine was like just meeting you guys and being in the room, and just us all being so open and even talking about like when the next time we're going to meet up is, like, even though we're all in different states, like talking about going to Florida or like wherever we decided to go. But I really enjoyed like just seeing how much I grew as a person, and like my color team grew together and just grew closer, and how vulnerable everyone was willing to be. Because at first, like, I felt like our team specifically was very quiet and like reserved, but then once we started doing like the dance battle or the singing or whatever, our group opened up a lot, and we were able to talk to each other about things that you would never think you would talk to somebody about or tell them. So,
and like for the biggest thing for me was kind of vulnerability. I'm not like, at times, you know, as a leader, I'm not very like vulnerable, or I am like a quiet type. But like once I got around like the right people and the people that are like-minded to me, it kind of allowed me to kind of open up and kind of be able to like share my knowledge and kind of let me be who I am. And also taught me to, even though people may not be like-minded as me, to still be able to be vulnerable and still open up, and people appreciate like who you are. So kind of being yourself in every situation you're in, no matter people are open to you or not.
Yeah, vulnerability was a big thing that week, especially for me, because I'm not a vulnerable person. And like Anthony was saying, like from that day, we were sitting in the room just talking about like our deepest things, was just something that made me realize like it's important to be vulnerable. And it made me take steps forward as a leader. I know I was talking to Nye, you know, you're talking about how you tore your ACL and how you were, you had a moment to be vulnerable about that. So how was that moment in the forum for you?
It was very crazy for me. So I'm like a month out of surgery. Well, I was a month out of surgery whenever I went to the forum. And this is like my first major injury. And I feel like I didn't really come to terms with how I emotionally felt about my injury until I went to this forum. And when I was sitting in the room with my color team, there was a boy who tore his ACL twice, and he was just saying like, you know, being in this room, he knows I might not say it, but she might be going through. And it's like, whoa, like, you don't know me from a can of paint, but like, you know how I feel. And there were so many people just coming up to me, even you, like talking about your experience. There's just so many things you wouldn't guess about people because you already have all these assumptions when you walk into the room. And then too, like the public speaker, the soccer coach, her talking about her injury and how she dealt with that. Like, it was very eye-opening to me. And then it just made me feel like it's okay to say you're not okay. Like, this is a normal thing to be emotionally hurt about, and that's okay. And I feel like if I wouldn't have gone to this forum, I would still be probably just faking my way through it. Like, I'm good every day. There's nothing wrong. I'm strong. And sometimes it's okay, even as a leader, to admit I'm not strong right now, because that's sometimes when you get the best out of your people, because they see you as just another one of them, which you are at the end of the day.
Yep, that's true. So basically just talking about coming out of it, you know, it's been a couple of weeks. So is there anything you guys took with you from the event that you've been applying at school with your team? Anyone could say anything, but yeah.
Mine is like habits. Like we talked a lot about habits and how they prep you for your future, or like whatever you do gets you ready or not ready. So I've been trying to get back to being more disciplined. Like I used to be really good at saying I was going to do something and do it, or just making sure that I'm doing the extra things outside of practice. But last year, at the end of the year, I did get injured, and that messed with me mentally, and it messed with my confidence a lot. And so going to this leadership thing in Baltimore, it helped me get my confidence back and get back to where I was before my injury. So just working through those things. And they always talked about like building yourself inside out. So being the leader you need to be for yourself, so that you, when it's time for you to be a leader for others, you're able to do that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. For me, I just say, like, again, vulnerability. Like before, I was very okay with just saying like I'm good and just continuing to walk straight, like into the locker room, the game. Like my mental could be off that day, but at the beginning of practice, everyone's like, you're good. I'm like, I'm good. And I think after leaving that event, making it a point to tell my teammates, like, if you're not okay, you need to say something, because it's going to affect everyone at the end of the day. It's not going to just affect you. It's going to affect your whole team. Cause you know, we all are a part of a team somehow, whether it's your family, we're all a part of something. So when I see Naya down, I'm going to be down. If I see Jada down, I'm going to be down. So it's like being okay with being vulnerable. And that's just something I've taken from Leadership Forum to my team. So, yeah. Anyone else take anything or no?
Probably communication. That's something that I knew that I struggle with personally. And I wanted to make sure that I can, like, be able to kind of take it away and kind of use it over my, like, team. Especially, like, those crucial conversations, you know, where what they say, like, when the emotions get high, or like the stakes get high, you know, being able to communicate like effectively, like with your teammates and stuff. So kind of holding my teammates accountable as much as I can, and kind of practicing those skills so I can be a better communicator for my team. Cause I know that that's why I struggle, and I want to bring that to my team.
Anthony, you took anything with you, Naya?
Yeah, I was going to say mine would probably be inclusive leadership. So I'm on a team where like, the team is kind of split. Well, last year it was split between like returners and transfers. And I felt like sometimes I didn't get to know the transfers well enough to, you know, deliver for them as a leader. So then at a point it looked like, oh, I only care about the people who have been here. And I never want it to be like that. So I think the session is talking about inclusive leadership and making it a point to get to know your other teammates. So something that I feel like I've brought back to my university now is I told my coach, like, I want to have 5 to 10 minutes with each player on my team and just talk to them, get to know them on a personal level outside of basketball, off the court, so that when things happen, they know I have their best interests in my heart. So, yeah.
Yeah, those relationships are important. Jada, Anthony?
I would say, like, the biggest thing I took away, because I'm not playing my fifth year. Like, I'm not going to take my fifth year. And that was, like, really hard for me, considering that basketball has been such a huge part of my life since I was in fifth grade. So it's kind of like I'm having, like, a crisis right now, like an identity crisis. And I think that the Leadership Forum, like, helped me with that. Like, I don't necessarily have to be a leader on the court. Like, I can be a leader within my life, like, going forward. So I really took away from what the last speaker had talked to us about. I forgot his name, but
Sprinkles.
Yes. Mr. Sprinkles. He said, never let fear change your decision. And I feel like I really took that, like, and ran with it. So I'm just trying to be a leader in my life, in my family, in my community. So, yeah.
And, you know, athletes are watching this. So some people may be going through the same thing as you, just deciding to just not take their fifth year. So do you have any advice for them? Maybe they're struggling, maybe they're okay with it. Just anything you would want to say to them?
I feel like you need to do what's best for you at the end of the day. Like, so I feel as though, like I said before, don't let fear change your decision. Don't let trying to please other people be the reason why you stay. Like, because that's going to hurt you at the end of the day. Like, a lot of people don't talk about athletes' mental health. We go through a lot of stuff. Like, and we have to, like, internalize it so that we can be, perform and be at our best for, like, our team, like, our university, all of that other type, like, all those other things. So, I mean, just make sure that you're internally okay with it and come to terms with the whole entire situation. It's not going to be overnight where you're just going to be like, okay, like, it's over with, it's done, like, I'm happy. But, like, you know, like, be at peace with yourself when you make the decision.
I like that. Anthony, anything?
Yeah, I'll probably say the session's talking about, like, choosing your heart. Like, I think they said one thing that's really stuck with me is, like, everything that's, like, good in life is on the other side of heart. And, like, it's hard to, like, put in work. It's hard to train at a high level. It's hard to eat right. It's hard to do all those things. But it's also hard to not play. It's hard to lose. It's hard to like do all the things that, you know, all the things that you don't want to happen to you. That's hard too. So like, just, I've been having that mentality and trying to like pour that into my team. Like, choose your heart. Like, either way it's going to be hard, but focus on the result that you want from the hard thing. And so that's really what I've been just trying to focus on every day, is like, it's going to be, it's hard either way, like, choose it. Choose the one that you want.
Yep. So, you know, going from the first day until the last day, again, like I said, I was boo crying, and it was hard for me to say bye to all these people. So what would you say, like, that last day was for you guys? You all don't have to talk, but, like, anyone that would want to say anything.
I would say it made me very appreciative of just the opportunity itself. And it's like, 4 days seemed like, oh Lord, it's going to be a long 4 days. These sessions are long, but it went by so fast, like in a blink of an eye. And it's like, you just have to be thankful. And like you said, like, I'm the type of person, like, I'm here for a reason. It was just so cool to see everything come full circle. So I would just say I left feeling very appreciative.
Yeah, felt that. Anyone else? No?
For me,
yeah, I was sad.
Go ahead.
Nah, for me, I don't know, it was a little 8, man. It's like, it wasn't long enough, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, you know, you're having a good time. You want it to last forever, but for me, I kind of miss it a little bit, kind of like want to go back. You know how, like, you really miss something, you can feel it in your heart. That was like that last day type of feeling was.
SAYLOR?
Mine's the kind of same as him. Like, I wasn't ready for it to be over. Like, it went by so. Ooh. Quick. Things. But everything ends for a reason, and it was time for us to go back to our universities and bring this to our teams and to SAC and to the whole university. But I was sad that it was ending because it went by way too fast.
It did. So I didn't really know what I was getting myself into when I was applying, when I answered the questions. Like, I didn't really know what was to come. So if you had any advice to give athletes that are going into this leadership forum and trying to apply and trying to get there, what would you guys say?
I would say, when you get there, do not waste time. Like, do not waste time networking. Do not waste time meeting people. Do not waste time asking questions. Do not waste time in your sessions. Like, write as many notes as you can. Be engaged in every single. I missed the half of the last session because I was. I didn't get up. My roommate was like, yo, bro, it's 7. Like, are you good? And I was like, yeah, I'm good. I'll be there in a minute. I woke up. It was like 8:45. I hurried up and ran out. But, like, just don't waste no time. Like, there's so much, like, value to be gotten from this experience. And, like, I feel like I wasted time because I was trying to be too cool in the beginning. And, like, I don't need to talk to anybody. I don't need to do whatever, whatever. But I could have, you know, used my time a lot more. It could have been a lot more that I could have used my time for. But just don't waste any time.
Yeah, I definitely agree with that.
I would say if you're contemplating on going or not, like, you should take this opportunity and go. Like, don't be afraid that you don't know anybody. Like, this is a time for you to network and meet new people and learn more about yourself. So just don't let your fear hold you back, because it's a great opportunity.
I would say don't be afraid to reach out to the people who are just running the event itself. So, like, there's so many people, so many things that go on behind the scenes, whether it's media, whether it's, like, organization. There are so many things that, like, we're majoring in and we're studying that we want to do. And these people who work for the NCAA, like, we're here for a reason. They know we have goals. They know that we're really hardworking. So you tell these people, hey, I'm so-and-so from this school. I want to do what you're doing one day. And, like, just pick their brain, because you can get a lot of information about leadership, but you can also just get a lot of information about what you want to do in your life outside of sports, just from being in that room that so many other people aren't in.
Yeah. Mike, Jada, any advice you give anyone?
I say just go in with an open mind. Mm-hmm. Like, you never know the amazing people that you'll meet, like, the relationships that you're going to build upon, like, just, like, outside of your color team, but, like, with other people, even, like the administrative people that were there. Like, I still, like, text them. They check on me and stuff like that. I feel like that's really cool. Like, it's a great opportunity. Like, this is definitely a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. Like, and if you get the chance, like Sailor said, go.
And my answer is going to be similar to everybody else, but kind of just take advantage of everything. You know, like, everything that they present to you, like Anthony said, like, make sure you're taking notes. You know, if there's somebody in the position that you want to be in, go, like, talk to them. Just like Naya said, like, everybody kind of hit it on a point. Just take advantage of every opportunity you get as soon as you, like, go to, like, this forum or this event. And, like, make sure you make, like, connections and kind of check in on those connections, too. Like, we still... like, the paint team still got a group chat, you know what I'm saying?
We
still
taking we got a group chat too.
Hey, look, hey, paint team for life, you feel me? So, yeah, make sure you check in, like, on your connections and stuff, and make sure you create those connections.
Yes.
Like, even to add on to that, like, they're legit, like, on the last day, like, when everybody was leaving, I was, like, grabbing my lunch, and I sat down next to this lady, and, like, I was, like, asking, like, for a charger port, and she, like, we started talking, and she was like, ask me what I want to do, and yada yada yada. Long story short, she's like a commissioner for associative commissioner for a conference, and she, like, knows a lot of people in the industry that I'm, like, interested in getting into. So, like, she gave me her number, and then we connected. After we got on a Zoom for like 30 minutes, talked about, like, career options. And now she's, like, plugging me in with somebody that is in the industry that I'm thinking about getting into. And, like, now we're about to have a Zoom. And she was like, any job that you are thinking about, ask me about it. I probably know somebody in that industry, and I'll help you. And it's just, like, I legit talked to her probably for 15 minutes max at the forum, like, on the last day. And, like, she's basically, like, anything you need, I'll help you. Like, I will help you get a job. Like, and so just, like, stuff like that, like, you can't, like, buy that anywhere else.
You can't.
You want to put her number in the Zoom chat?
I'm saying, you want to tell all these people that before you tell us in the group chat? That's insane. You can't tell nobody about nothing.
Hey, look, let me get my money first. Let me get my money first.
You can put everyone on game.
Spread the love. Like, spread the money.
Right.
Like,
I got you.
What's crazy is I saw you, because me and Naya were getting our sandwiches too, and I saw you talking to this girl, and I'm like, bro, who is he talking to for this long?
Yes,
I was like,
yes.
You good? He's like, yeah.
He out here making connections. That's what it is.
He's been plotting this whole time. Crazy. But no, yeah, for me, my advice would just be to go. Like, I will never forget that experience for the rest of my life. You don't have weeks like that. You don't have weeks like that in your life. And just go. Like, that's it. Like everyone was saying, go, don't hesitate. Put everything forward. Just take me a piece from everyone. Like Anthony was saying, be yourself from the beginning. You don't gotta be cool from the, just be you. And yeah, just go. That's it. But
one thing I would say is even if you don't get the opportunity to go to this, like use your connections and use your resources, even throughout your school. You have a lot of people that you can go and talk to and they will help you. So like, don't let the university use you. Make sure that you use the university and use everything that they provide for you, because a lot of people don't know that they have access to certain things. So if you're interested in something or you're wondering about it, like, make sure you go and reach out. And if you reach out to the wrong person, they'll direct you to the right place and where you need to be and who you need to talk to.
Yes. Thank you, Saylor. So that's it. You know, I just want to say thank you to you guys for being on this episode. I miss you guys.
I miss y'all too.
Thank you for having us. We miss you too.
Like, dang, I want to go back right now.
But, Florida soon.
Florida, everyone come to Florida as soon as possible.
Hey, we're in Florida though.
Fort Lauderdale.
Oh yeah, that's close to my area. Yeah, that's an hour away. Like,
I know you're in Miami. Everyone, we need to figure this out. Like, we need to figure this out because it's too long.
Summer. Yes. Like, come on. I'm ready.
Just let me know. Like, let me know. But yeah, thank you for being on this episode. I really appreciate you guys. Make sure you guys go follow them on all their platforms. I'll put them in the caption and follow the course on all of its platforms. Stay up to date with what we're doing and stay tuned for the next drop next Monday with another Florida athlete. And yeah, anyone want to say anything before they go? Bye. Anything? No.
Bye. Thanks for having us.
Bye. This was fun.
Green team. Green team for life.
Pink team. It's always purple.
Hey, it's pink team. Why
is it not here?
Hey, it's so
different. Okay.
PP for life.
But yeah, make sure y'all stay tuned for next week. I appreciate y'all. Bye. 9 favorite show.
Shameless.
Mike, favorite season.
Season? Spring.
Jada, favorite song.
Tina Montana by Megan Thee Stallion.
Saylor, favorite team.
Viking.
Anthony, favorite restaurant.
Texas Roadhouse Rolls.
Naya, favorite player.
Elena Deladon.
Mike, favorite food.
Blue State.
Jada, favorite brand.
Nike.
All right, this one's for everyone. What's everyone's favorite word in another language?
Konnichiwa.
LOL.
My thing is going to be Ola. I don't know.
That's so crazy.
That is reading.
Your brother's a rapper?
Bomba clap. Bomba clap.
You can't say that.